Okay, this project is home automation, or we call it as smart home automation using IoT. We are developing this project using Arduino controller. So here is a program for the Arduino controller that I have written. I am using two pins in Arduino board. Pin 8 is for light and pin 7 is for fan. So I am making the initial setups here, and then this is a loop where we transmit a message from Arduino to transmit a message from mobile to Arduino board using Bluetooth. So what this program does is it receives the message that is coming from mobile, and that message is checked with, compared with this string light on. The message whatever is received from mobile is stored in a variable command. So if this command is receiving light on, then that particular pin assigned to the light, that is here, pin number 8 will go high. And if I say light off, particular pin will go low. Similarly, if the command has fan on, then the pin assigned to fan will go high, and pin assigned to fan will go low when fan off. So here we'll try to see how this connections are done. So we have a USB to UART cable. This is USB to UART cable here. What I'm doing is I'm connecting this USB to UART here. So this is a UART type. So I'll connect this to this here. After connection, we can see a default LED, pin number 13 LED will glow. So here on the board, we have a small steps to be made. Click on tools. Then board will be automatically selected. Go to Arduino Uno board. COM3 is also selected. So you first have to compile the program using this. So it says done compiling. After that we have to upload. Uploading the code to the Arduino. So done uploading, the program has been uploaded now. The program is uploaded now. Now here we have to make few changes. Few changes in the sense, few connections we have to make. So this is Bluetooth module. This is the Bluetooth module, where it has 4 pins, RXD, TXD, ground and VCC. So there are VCC pins on the board, ground pins on the board, you can connect. So this is VCC. What I will do, from the board there is one VCC pin here, pin number 5. So this is a VCC pin where I am connecting. This is the VCC pin. So I'll take a common VCC here. I'll keep that pin here. This is the VCC point. Wherever I need VCC, I can use it. So that is my VCC. Now I'll connect my Bluetooth VCC. What I'll do? So Bluetooth is having, this is the VCC of Bluetooth. I'll take my VCC. And Bluetooth also has a ground point. So I'll take my ground point. Grounds, there are 3 grounds available on the board. So I'll use one ground here. This is a ground point. Next, what I'll do, this is RXD and TXD. So these two pins have to be connected onto the board. RxTxt, see, TxT on Bluetooth will go to RxT on board. TxT on Bluetooth will go to, so I am, this is my TxT on Bluetooth, so I will plug it into RxT of board. Similarly, RxD on board, this is RxD, whatever I am showing here, this is RxD on board, it will go to TxD on the, RxD on Bluetooth will go to TxD on the board. Now, we need to make these connections. We have to drive these relays. So we require two points here. Now we have to drive these loads using these relays. So these relays will be driven according to the logic that we give from Arduino to those relays. So we have connected pin number 8 and pin number 7. So pin number 8 is our light. So I'll take pin number 8 on the board. I'll connect it to one load. And pin number 7 is one more load. That is fan. We'll connect it here. 7 is fan. We'll connect it here. So this is pin number 7. Pin number 7 is fan. So this is we can just need to change them. And we also need to connect VCC. So this is VCC. We'll take from here the VCC point. And we need to connect ground. Ground is available here. From this point we'll take the ground. We'll connect ground as well. Now, using application, we can drive the loads. We need to connect. I am connecting a bulb here. I am connecting a bulb to this holder. And to that bulb I am giving supply. Similarly, we will be connecting a fan here. To that load, I am connecting a fan to that terminal, and to the fan I am connecting
supply as well. Now the setup is ready. We can control these loads using Android mobile.
Now we have a Android app in Google Store, AMR Wise. So we can install that app, and once we install that app, there is one button, there is one option here. Click on that. We say connect robot. We have to put on the Bluetooth of this module on. That means we have to put Bluetooth on in this mobile, and then using that app, say when you will come back, I'll show you again. First step is you put the Bluetooth on, then go to this option in that app, then say connect robot. No, this is the different thing I pressed. I have to say, I'll come back. I have to go to this option, then say connect robot. Now whichever Bluetooth are available to this mobile, that means HC05, this is a Bluetooth here, right? We have used. So this is a Bluetooth to which we send the message, and that message goes to this controller, and controller drives those relays. Okay, so that is HC05. We connect it to HC05. Now it says connecting. If it says connected, if it doesn't say, then try again. Say connect, then go to connect robot, then choose that HC05, say connecting. So it says connected. Now it is connected. Now in this app, what I'll do, you can observe. So that load I have connected, one load is fan, the other load is bulb. In this app, what I'll do, I'll click on this mic and say okay. See, light on. When I say light on, the bulb will be put on. Again I click on that, say light off, the particular light will be off. I'll show again. See, light on, light is put on, light off. Similarly, we'll see that as well, the fan. I'll hold this app here, try to record both. So I'll put it fan on. A fan is on. I'll say fan off. Look at this message, fan off. So fan goes off. I'll say again, look at the message here. Now fan is off. Now fan off, on. Sorry, I misspelled it. Fan on. Once I put fan on, that particular fan will be put on immediately. Now I'll put off. Fan off. Fan is put off. So this is how we can control n number of home appliances using Arduino controller through a smartphone. So sitting at a place, this is basically used for older people, elder people who cannot come out of the places they are sitting, or who cannot move frequently. If they have to control the home appliances like refrigerator, fan, etc., they can try out this project, and this is very helpful. Thank you.